3, 2, 1 start. The provincial authorities have been taking precautionary measures, or so we have been told, to cope with emergency situations that could result from the extreme monsoon rains expected this year, full stop. Over the last few decades, Pakistan's cities, big and small, have experienced extreme episodes of rain-inflicted flooding that has claimed lives and destroyed property, full stop. This is because our cities are not prepared to deal with the unpredictable rains that are becoming a routine feature of the monsoons due to climate change, full stop. New paragraph. And temporary measures can only partially mitigate the damage from flooding, full stop. Urban flooding is not a phenomena specific to Pakistan, full stop. Cities, even in the developed world, are confronting the issue, as global warming is inducing climatic changes and causing more and more extreme weather events, full stop. Urbanization itself, particularly unplanned urbanization in developing countries such as ours, has created the perfect conditions for pluvial flooding, full stop. This is necessitating solutions to control and mitigate the effects of urban flooding, with governments building and rebuilding climate resilient urban infrastructure to protect their people and the economy from damage, full stop. New paragraph. This is the area on which Pakistani authorities must concentrate, full stop. Unfortunately, we are still focusing on firefighting rather than diverting our resources to better urban planning, full stop. Pakistan is among the top countries most impacted by climate change, which is another reason why we should be instituting preventive measures, such as investing in urban governance, storm water drainage, storage and management systems, as well as solid waste disposal management, full stop.